No, it won't start. Yes, I've called and I'm waiting for the service truck. Yes, I know the urgency of this delivery, but there's not much I can do about it. No, I'm not happy about it either. Maybe I should have taken a different job.
Downtime, costly repairs, unhappy drivers, unhappy customers, pressure, and stress. Picture yourself in that driver's seat, or maybe something similar has happened to you. There are many forces battling against your need for uptime and fleet performance. The wrong type of battery can't be one of them. The wrong type of battery turns routine maintenance into emergency replacements. The wrong type of battery will impact your credibility and the bottom line. The wrong type of battery might not work properly with your charging equipment. In order to best determine which batteries are right for your fleet, we brought in the experts of Jeff Muir and John Cathy from East Penn Manufacturing to help us figure out what went wrong and what we can do to prevent it from happening in the future. I hear the terms flooded and AGM tossed around a lot. Why would I want one over the other?
Absorbed glass mat, or AGM, is the latest technology and offers the best-in-class life and performance in the class 6 or 8 truck applications. Fleets or operators wanting to maximize product life and improve the total cost of ownership will want to spec a battery that maximizes life cycle and has added protection against battery failure.
So what causes batteries to die an untimely death like mine did, and what can I do to prevent it?
You know, batteries fail for a variety of reasons. However, misapplication and improper maintenance are the most common reasons for premature removal. For example, an operator would not want to try the hotel in a day cab application. So why would the industry want to use a starting battery in a sleeper cab application? It makes a lot of sense that sleeper cabs, APUs, lift gates, and other applications with high cycling demand require a battery designed for maximizing cycle life. And this is important. It must be tough enough to provide its cycle service in the most demanding applications. That is why things like heat protection and vibration resistance is critical in battery longevity and product reliability. Batteries also experience heat in warmer months that causes them to lose the necessary capacity and resiliency to have the power needed for wintertime temperatures.
Are batteries subjected to a lot of heat?
Well, that's a great question. Since 2011, truck configurations have caused battery boxes to reach much higher temperatures. Some battery boxes even reach 140 degrees Fahrenheit or beyond.
That's hot enough to fry an egg.
Yes, it is, Josh. And temperatures keep rising. Even in cooler climates, battery boxes are up and away from airflow, a position very close to heat-generating items, causing the temperature in this metal box to continue to rise. Heat is hard on batteries. These types of temperatures are detrimental.
So then are batteries especially designed to withstand these detrimental high temperatures?
Surprisingly, there's only one that is designed with thermal shield and protection. Fahrenheit makes a real difference in the fight to withstand heat, which, by the way, also protects its performance when tested in the extreme cold.
I've also heard you mentioned about making sure your AGM battery is compatible with your off-truck charger. Can you better explain that?
Sure, Josh. Let's start with something called charge reflection. This speaks to when a charger needs to recognize the number of amps absorbed in order to charge properly. Some AGM batteries have a charge reflection that does not work with very popular shop chargers. The good news is, with Fahrenheit AGM batteries, you don't have to worry about this. Just make sure to charge them on a recommending setting for AGM, and you won't have the same incompatibility issues that can occur with some other type of AGM products.
Okay, well, let's talk dollars and cents. What is having a battery with thermal shielding technology going to cost me?
Well, it's actually very competitive, if not lower, than alternative AGM batteries. However, I think it's important to look at what the cost will be when not investing in thermal shielding technology. The investment in Fahrenheit would more than pay for itself if you avoided emergency costs incurred from a heat-related incident.
Now let's add customer dissatisfaction because of increased downtime, driver retention, or the possibility of losing contracts over a dead battery. More protection against these critical things make Fahrenheit batteries an even smarter decision.
Okay, that does make a lot of sense. Here at Fleet Equipment Magazine, we realize how it's more important than ever to have parts that you can trust, and there's not much more critical than batteries. In order to keep up with evolving technology, truck parts need to be designed smarter. High quality, innovative parts keep trucks on the road instead of stranded on the shoulder, making it vital for parts like the battery to be built smart. That's why products like Fahrenheit are developed to really meet today's heavy-duty truck needs.
I'll see you back out on the road.